Hello, everyone. This is Rev Paul with Miracles One, and welcome to another episode of Insights on A Course in Miracles. Over this past week, we've been working with lessons within the workbook for students. It's lessons 100 through 107. And I went through these lessons and just pulled out some sentences that stood out to me in each one here. So let's go ahead and jump in right in and take a look at these. In lesson 101, God's will for me is perfect happiness. Jesus says that God's will for you is perfect happiness because there is no sin and suffering is causeless. Joy is just and pain is but the sign you have misunderstood yourself. Fear not the will of God, but turn to it in confidence that it will set you free from all the consequences sin has wrought in feverish imagination. Now, if you're new to A Course in Miracles or to these ideas, this idea that there is no sin, that it is causeless, that it is an imagination, that could be kind of hard to swallow. But as you continue to study A Course in Miracles and work with it, you'll hear this same message over and over again, that sin is not real. There is no such thing. We've made it all up in our ego minds. And this goes back to the idea that we were created as God created us originally, which is exactly like himself. That's the spiritual part of us. And then we went through this experience where we see that spiritual part of us seemed to fall asleep and start having this dream that it was born in a body and it's living this life that goes through pain, misery, suffering, guilt, sin, the belief in sin. And just like a normal dream, when you fall asleep at nighttime and you have a dream, during the time of the dream, it seems very real. And then you wake up at some point after the dream is over or in the middle of the night or in the morning, the dream just completely vanishes. It goes away and you recognize that it was nothing more than a dream. Well, the same thing is going on with us here with, you know, this life that seems very real to us is nothing more than a dream. And someday the spiritual part of us will awaken from the dream and all of this would just vanish and go away, to include the idea of sin and pain. So his big message here is that it's not necessary. In lesson 102, I share God's will for happiness for me. Today, we try to loose its weakened hold still further. And to realize that pain is purposeless, without a cause, and with no power to accomplish anything. It cannot purchase anything at all. It offers nothing and does not exist. And everything you think it offers you is lacking in existence like itself. You have been slave to nothing. Be you free today to join the happy will of God. When God created us, he created us as love, and love is joy, and joy is happiness, all right? That has never changed. There's just an illusion of change kind of wrapped around it again, all right? And we have this belief that we need to suffer and atone for sins and mistakes that we've made. And he's saying, this is all a waste of time. Why don't you just tune into and go back to your core of who you really are as a happy, joyful, loving, spiritual being. And you have a choice. We all have a choice. We can learn how to do this now by going within in meditation and reaching down deep inside of us during silent meditations and discovering the truth about ourselves, the real part of ourselves, that spiritual part of ourselves that's deep down in there. And when you reach that light of your true self, you will begin to experience the joy, the freedom, the happiness, the peace that you really are. And then when you come back out of it, you can bring it with you and you know it's there. You know it's real. You know it's you. It's a part of you and who you really are. And now you can walk the world in that kind of state and bless all of those around you who have not done that yet, who have not awakened. That is part of our job, is to be happy here. In lesson 103, God being love is also happiness. He says here that fear is associated then with love, and its results become the heritage of minds that think what they have made is real. These images, with no reality in truth, bear witness to the fear of God. Forgetting being love, he must be joy. This basic error we will try again to bring the truth today and teach ourselves. God being love is also happiness. To fear him is to be afraid of joy. So that's one of the things that we have to kind of work through, is we have either a conscious or an unconscious belief, actually fear of God. We may not realize it, but when you go within to practice trying to reach that light inside of you and discovering the God self inside of you, you will notice that, at least I noticed in the beginning of those practices many years ago, that I felt afraid. I felt afraid to go within and find the light. I felt afraid of God. And then most of it was unconscious. I didn't even realize it. And Jesus is inviting us and saying, hey, don't worry. Don't be afraid of God, because God is love. Love is joy. Joy is happiness. And when you do make that connection, you're going to actually discover that he is your God, creator, is your best friend. And I had that experience many years ago when I had a personal experience of revelation with God. And I was amazed at how friendly, gentle, loving, and wonderful my experience was with God in that particular encounter, if you will. So recognize that we have a fear of God, but walk through that, push through that, ask the Holy Spirit to help you through that, let it go. You don't have to worry about, God is not going to punish you. All of that is just a bunch of garbage, and it has nothing to do with God, nothing to do with truth and who you are, really. In lesson 104, I seek but what belongs to me in truth. His are the gifts that were inherited before time was, and that will still be ours when time has passed into eternity. His are the gifts that are within us now, for they are timeless, and we need not wait to have them. They belong to us today. Therefore, we choose to have them now, and know in choosing them in place of what we made, we but unite our will with what God wills. So what a wonderful message here. All of the gifts that God gave to us in our creation, way before time began, are still within us now, all of them, because they're timeless, all right? And the nice thing about it is that we don't have to wait to find them. We can begin finding them right now as we practice these lessons. When you go within and you continue to practice and you learn how to quiet your mind and you be still and wait with a quiet expectation in that quiet, peaceful place deep down inside of you, miracles begin to happen. Gifts begin to come to you. Gifts begin to happen. You're going to experience flashes of light. You're going to experience sudden waves of peace. You're going to experience physical healings. You're going to experience hearing the voice of God speak to you in all kinds of other gifts, okay? Peace, joy. When you get connected with that inner light, you're going to feel joy well up inside of you. It just, because it's there and you're allowing it to come up. So there's so many gifts that are waiting, and you can have them now. You just need to keep practicing every single day. I start my day and I end my day by going within and trying to receive a gift. All right. You got to go for your gifts. They're there and you can have them every day. And when you start to receive them on a regular basis, you'll find that as you go through your day, when you're not meditating and you're doing your life, you're doing your work, you're doing your walk, whatever it is through the day, you feel safer. You feel more joyful. You feel happier. You feel secure, right? Because you know, you get this grounding in you at the beginning of the day before you go out and embrace the world, okay? Fantastic gifts, way better than the way it used to be when we would get up feeling anxious about going to work, right? Get yourself grounded in God every single morning before you go out there. And I guarantee you, you will have a happier, more joyful life. All right. Lesson 105, God's peace and joy are mine. So tell yourself, God's peace and joy are mine. And close your eyes a while and let his voice assure you that the words you speak are true. And then you got lesson 106, let me be still and listen to the truth. Lesson 106 is one of my all-time favorite lessons for learning how to hear the voice of God inside of you speak to you, okay? There are different levels of the voice, but there is this one voice, and this is the one he's referring to here. There is an audible voice deep inside of you that you can learn how to hear. And when you hear it, you will know without a doubt that it is the voice for God speaking to you. It is the voice of God. And it is a joyful experience when it happens. He always has wonderful things to say to you. And when he does, I just guarantee you, you will have a smile on your face all through the day. Especially when you hear, he says, listen and hear your father speak to you through his appointed voice. Hear only him today. Do not wait to reach him longer. All right. Hear and be silent. He would speak to you. So I want to reiterate that Jesus is speaking very literal to us here. When he says to listen with an open mind, then you will hear the mighty voice of truth. Listen and hear your father speak to you. He literally means you will hear the voice of God talk to you, all right? And I want you to know that these are not metaphors. This is very literal. It is there. It took me a lot of practice, many weeks and months of practice before I actually heard it the first time, but it really is there. And I guarantee you, it is well worth the effort. As a matter of fact, once it happens and you know it's there, you want to go back. You are re-motivated to continue practicing these lessons and to learn how to do this. It is a fantastic, wonderful experience to hear God speak to you. Total, just amazing, all right? I can't say enough about it, all right? So, and then lesson 107. Truth will correct all errors in my mind. And he's talking about, you know, the truth of who we really are. When you sink down in there and you get connected with the light of your true self and you begin to hear the voice of your true self speaking to you, you know, God kind of coming in through that channel. And when you rest there in him who is yourself, then let him lead you gently to the truth, which will envelop you and give you peace so deep and tranquil that you will return to the familiar world reluctantly. So you can get into this space where it is so amazing, so peaceful, so wonderful, and so happy and safe that you're like, oh, this is awesome, where you're free of fear for a few moments or a little while. And you don't want to come back. You want to stay there. And when you do come back, you bring some of that back with you and you have a happier, safer, more secure day. What a wonderful way to start your day each and every day. So please make sure you keep practicing out there. If you're getting a little bit worn out, recommit, re-engage. It's totally worth it. And as these gifts start to come to you more and more, and they get more powerful in their your personal experience with them, you'll be rocking and rolling and have no trouble with wanting to keep working on them. So hang in there. And thank you very much for joining with me today. I love you all. Thank you for being my mighty companions. And we'll see you again real soon. Bye-bye.
For more A Course in Miracles video teachings, our study groups, podcasts, self-study courses, articles, and personal A Course in Miracles coaching, access our website at MiraclesOne.org.